Okay, so today what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about shares and dividends. And you've probably heard this language before, but what we're talking about is owning stock in a company, owning a share in a company, which will entitle you to a share of the profits. And that's where that term comes from. You're going to be getting a share of the profits. So what we're going to do is we're going to find out how we can determine how much profit you would get per share. And then we're going to talk a little bit about how you would know which investments would make a better buy based on their past performance. And remember, past is no indication of what's going to happen in the future, but at least if it did well in the past, perhaps. And then we're going to talk a little bit about what dividends are and how they're earned. Okay? So the first thing I want to do is talk about how to find how to find the profit per share. Now, you don't usually only own one share, right? But if you did, then you would have just the one share. So usually you have more than one share. And there are a limited number of shares in the company. Say, for example, the company only sold 100 shares and you owned part of them, then what we're going to do is find out how much income or profit you would get from your percentage of shares, which means that we first need to find the percent that you own. And we've found percents before, right? Remember that finding a percent, that's just simply the part over the what? Over the whole amount, yeah? Okay, so think of it for a moment. If it's the part, that means the part you own, right? And the whole in this case is going to be the total number of shares. So to find the percent you own, you're just going to put the number of shares owned and then you're just going to divide that by the total number of shares. So they're going to have to give you those two pieces of information so that you can then find the percent. Okay? Once you find that, you want to make sure that you write it as a percent, which means simply multiply it by 100 and then put the percent symbol in, right? To change it the other way, you divide by 100. And then what you're going to do is simply multiply that percent times the total profit. And that amount is your share. And that's where that idea of shares comes from, the name, because you're sharing the profit and the risk, obviously, with others. Okay. So relatively straightforward. All we're doing here, if you want to relate it back to what we've done, it's simply a percent of a number. So you'll see that the main idea here is the same. We're simply taking a percent of a number. So keep that in mind as you go. If you can come up with a recurring theme, then it doesn't seem like every day we're doing something new. We're doing the same mathematics, but in different scenarios or different types of scenarios. Okay? So now, let's talk about the next thing we're going to find, and then we'll come in and do some examples. The next thing we want to do is we want to find what's called the price to earnings ratio. Now, anytime you see that word ratio, you should think fraction. And remember that as a fraction, you can divide it out and turn it into a decimal, or you could divide it out and turn that decimal into a percent, right? So all of those are ideas of ratios, but they all come from the same basic start. They start with a fraction. And the price to earnings ratio, so price to earnings ratio, is simply found by doing the market share price So in other words, how much they're charging per share. So the market, just you're just going to go out and buy these shares. So that market share price, and you're going to divide it by the annual earnings per share. Now, the good news for you is this is one of your formulas. So you don't have to memorize it. You just have to know how to use it, and you need to know what it means. Okay? So the first thing is just do the division. Second, change to a percent. And we typically use just one decimal place for these. Don't get too carried away. You might get something with a lot of decimal places. Round it. Don't just drop them off, though, but round it to one decimal place. And then we need to answer the idea. We need to know what it means. What does the price-to-earnings ratio mean? What it means is the smaller price you can pay, the better, right? You want to pay the smallest price and get the most money for it. And so if the number on the bottom is how much you earned and it gets bigger, so remember when you divide by a bigger number, what happens to your total answer? It gets what? Smaller and smaller, right? So we want the lowest possible price to earnings ratio we can have. So the lower, the better. So when you're answering the question is always going to be, what is the price to earnings ratio as a percent? And you're going to be comparing several stocks. And the one that is the best value is the one with the lowest ratio. Okay? You want to pay the least amount possible and get the most amount of money. All right. And again, this one is on your formula sheet, so you'll be able to use it. Now, next, or last, actually, we want to talk about what's called a dividend. Some companies don't share their profits with you. Instead, they pay you what's called a dividend. So you're earning money based on how many stocks you have. Okay, and so what we need to do is find what's called the dividend yield. Oops, sorry, I before E. Okay. So yield simply means how much money they're going to pay you. And of course, that's based on two things. First of all, if you own more stocks, they're going to pay you more money, right? The dividend is going to be higher. And if their profit is high, then they can afford to pay more dividends. Make sense? So keep those in mind. Now, this is another one. You're lucky the formula is there on your formulas page, so you don't have to memorize it, but you do need to know how to find it because it's not going to tell you the whole part. So the first thing we need to do is take the number of shares times the dividend per share. And that's going to equal the total dividend. Okay. Now, once you've found that, we want to find out how much that dividend is as a ratio compared to share price. So that's the second part. The dividend yield is, again, a ratio, so that means a fraction. And it's simply the dividend, which you found in step one, divided by the share price. And of course, just like all of these other ratios, we want to convert to a percent. Okay. And then we'll be able to answer some questions about dividend questions based on that percent. All right. So most of it is finding percents of numbers or finding a particular ratio and turning it into a percent. So skills that we've done before, you just have to make sure you remember which one. All right. So keep those notes in front of you because we're going to go to some examples and I'm going to call on you for answers.